Mitchell, my friend, you know, became a pilot for Air India, called me for a grand dinner. But he has shared one thing on a very sad note. Raju, when I was landing my flight 20 years back in Bangalore International Airport, I could not see a building surrounded by light green trees. But nowadays, when I land a flight in an international airport, I could not see a tree covered by a heap of garbage. My dear Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster, my story is not very strange to this. In 1995, conductor has shouted, "Indira Nagar!" I took out my suitcases and landed in Indira Nagar, looked around, I felt like heaven. And people like Bangalore for different reasons. They're 300. Dangoba, why do you like Bangalore?
Because of the greenery and
the weather. Ramesh, why do you like Bangalore?
Because of Rangoba.
Why do you like Bangalore? Yeah. There could be 100 reasons. For me, very few and critical reasons are, I like shopping culture and amazing food joints and the salubrious weather across 365 days and people fantastic. They call me for a cup of coffee whenever I ring the bell, and Namma Bengaluru became my Bengaluru, and I say Bangalore is my native place. Of course, everything is going very well. But recently, when I come across, this is my Bangalore, Namma Bangalore. Recently, the news that has hit the paper and internet has touched and confused me a lot. Am I living in so-called Garden City or Carpet City? I question myself, like my friend who want to resign from pilot job, he could not see garbage from the sky. Can I resign from Bangalore? Venkat, do you want to resign from Bangalore or do you want to take some responsibility? Hence, I called so many people over phone and I asked him, what would be the root cause for this garbage problem? Can you suggest one solution? They have given me a lot of ideas and I have prepared a fact-finding report to sum it up, some root causes and of course few solutions as well. In the end, let us go through some root causes. Huge influx of migrants. Of course, I am a migrant, successful migrant. Like me, so many people from different states just come here for a job, they will settle permanently. They won't come, go back. But lack of high-end machinery and infrastructure to collect the garbage is not matching in tune with population growth. And agitation by villagers very close to the dump yard, what we have, they are saying suffocating with a lot of smell and fearing about health problems, they are blocking all the trucks leading to the dump yards. And lack of professionalism in BPP management leads almost disputes between low-end staff properly being not paid and they are not taken care of and they don't have proper education. Fifth one, dispute between old contractor and new contractors. I was surprised to read a news article yesterday that old contractor who lost the contract bringing the garbage from outside the city, dumping in some area where new contractor was suffering to lift existing material. The last root cause was lack of citizens' awareness. I have one friend have a car, he comfortably lift all his home garbage and comfortably park his car in the roadside, look around and dump on the road and manage to the office. That is the one, you know, that worries me. My dear friends, what is the impact? Environmental scientist Dr. Vikram has warned of an outbreak of plague if heaps of garbage are allowed to pile up at various locations we can comfortably see. I need not show you. In 1998, Bangalore has witnessed a massive plague which has costed 50,000 lives. Do you want to see one more plague? What can we do? Simply, we can club all the vegetables in our home and throw it into the neighbor's empty side, or we can do something and stretch out. Civilians should avoid dumping waste on the road whenever they want and should be educated. Separate their garbage in three packets. First one is kitchen garbage. Second one is all plastic covers and related to plastic material. Third one is sanitary items and medical equipment. And you should inform to your BPMD people that every month, every day, I am ready to give these three covers separately. They will be very happy to collect all those three covers. And dumping yard should be decentralized. We have only two or three right now. We should have more dumping yard around the city so that you can avoid trucks going all the way and dumping and coming back. And BPMD should be overseen by autonomous civic bodies who will represent the retired IAS officer and defense officer so that we can minimize influence of politicians. The government should allocate sufficient funds to procure high-end machineries to corporations so that they can lift material very fastly to meet the requirement of collection. And fifth one is BPMD staff should be educated and how to use all this material. And they should be properly supervised by higher authority whether they are doing their duty or not. The last one would be government should encourage entrepreneurs to process the waste through a new technology called biomining, through which we can produce power and biogas and manure. This would be the final and ultimate solution. And yesterday, our chief minister had a meeting with the budding entrepreneurs. They were seriously discussing out. So if all of us are lucky, you can see a lot of entrepreneurs who will be into garbage processing and make wealth for the country. My dear Toastmaster, God lives in cleanliness. I have associated with various forums and visited a lot of slums to educate about the importance of keeping cleanliness. You can comfortably keep your house clean and pat yourself and come out. Assist, coordinate with your local community people. Tell them, I am ready. Shall we go out and educate people to clean our community and colony? At least our Sunday makes a lot of difference to the country. Go to those parts.